Before we start, though, just I thought I'd let you know that this is, of course, if you haven't read already, Jim Stafford's birthday party. Just like any good venue, we've arranged and prepared for a couple of very, very interesting surprises for Jim, and we're going to be doing that a little bit later on in the evening during the intermission. Our show is going to be starting in just a moment. It's been a while since Jim Stafford's been back in the area. I spoke with him earlier. He did do a show, though, I think night before, in Lake Wales. Anybody know where that is? Yeah, not far from here. So Jim really didn't have to travel that far to get here. But this is his first big show back here in Central Florida in the last 20 years, according to Jim. He said that earlier. So you're getting all set for a very, very big treat. I did want to let you know about something about Jim, in case some of you are a little bit new to Jim. A lot of you came from a long ways away and are good friends with Jim, maybe are from his earlier career in Polk County, and we're certainly glad to have you here. But for those of you that don't know a lot about Jim, let me tell you some about Jim Stafford. A national TV star, songwriter, comedian, fantastic guitarist, and a live performer. Jim, also known as James Wayne Stafford, was born to a musical family in Eloise, right outside Winter Haven, and he was playing in his first band at age 14. While still in his teens, Jim put together a band called The Legends with his friend, songwriter Bobby Braddock, Kent Lavoie, and Graham Parsons, each member going on to huge fame in the music business. Bobby Braddock is a song producer and songwriter, wrote songs like He Stopped Loving Her Today for George Jones, also I Want to Talk About Me, great song by Toby Keith, Divorce for Tammy Wynette, and more. Kent Lavoie formed the group Lobo, known for the song Me and You and A Dog Named Boo, and the late Graham Parsons of the Byrds is noted to be one of the creators of the country rock sound that came out of the late 60s. So Jim was with some huge friends. The four of them started playing sock hops, Elks clubs, veteran halls, any place that would let him play. As soon as he graduated from high school, Jim went to Nashville, where he was a backup musician for Jumpin' Bill Carlisle. It was during this time that he began his famous one-man band act. He also continued to hone his songwriting skills, focusing on novelty songs because he felt his singing voice wasn't really that good. Well, one day, when performing in Clearwater, he reunited with his hometown friend, Kent Lavoie. Stafford asked Kent if he would perform the song he had written called Swamp Witch, but Kent convinced Jim to perform it himself. That was a good thing, because the song Swamp Witch eventually made its way to producer Mike Curb, who signed Jim to the MGM record label. Swamp Witch was released in 1973, and it became a huge hit. MGM then released what is probably the most popular and successful song, Spiders and Snakes. Spiders and Snakes would become a million-selling record. The song was composed by Stafford and David Bellamy, one half of the superstar country duo, the Bellamy Brothers. Spiders and Snakes, it was a smash hit on both pop and country charts. Next, the song My Girl Bill, which did better on the pop charts than the country charts and was Jim's biggest hit in England. His next hit was Wildwood Weed, and it did very well too, reaching the top 10. Well, by now, Jim had become a national celebrity, and he got the chance to host his own summer television variety show on the ABC television network. It was called The Jim Stafford Show. Although Stafford's quirky songs bought him some fame, the show also gave him a chance to showcase his exceptional ability as a guitar player. Well, in 1980, Jim appeared in Clint Eastwood's Any Which Way You Can and wrote another hilarious song called Cow Patty. The following year, he hosted yet another network television show called Nashville on the Road with Rex Allen Jr. and Sue Powell, and composed three songs for a Disney animated feature called The Fox and the Hound. During the rest of the 80s, Stafford performed in Las Vegas and at small concerts and country fairs. He also served a stint as head writer on the Smothers Brothers Comedy Hour. Well, in 1990, Jim was well into his career doing things by the book. He was showing up in one town after the other, one night after the other, doing the gig, getting paid, and heading to the next town in time for the next night's show. Well, then he discovered Branson, Missouri. He thought, hey, what if I open a theater here? And instead of me traveling from one town to the other, the fans can do the traveling and I can stay put. Well, that's what he did, and he's still in Branson. Well, actually, down the hallway right now. His wife, Ann, who is here tonight, has heard all his jokes, knows all the words to the songs, and besides raising their children, helps him run the theater. Get ready, folks, for the best show you've ever seen. Right here in front of your very eyes in the Red Rose Ballroom, the Jim Stafford Show is just about ready to begin.
Visit from a master of comedy and song. Please welcome the star of our show, Jim Stafford.
Thank you, everybody. I'm going to start with a line that's absolutely true. My daddy was a guitar man. He was the best I ever saw. Daddy did his picking out on the road, and he liked to kill my ma. She blamed it all on his guitar. She said, boy, don't even start to even think about learning how to pick that thing, or you'll break your mama's heart. Don't tell mama I'm a guitar picker. She'll think I've lost my mind. Mama knows where a guitar goes. Trouble's close behind. I could fight and drink and rob a bank, and I could raise all kinds of... Well, don't you tell mama I'm a guitar picker. Why, she thinks I'm just in jail. Got too hot lick, been saving it up for tonight, and here it comes. Gracious. I got me a job as a guitar man on a bar called the Rusty Saddle. Till my mama hit the stage in an absolute rage and chased me home with a ping pong paddle. And that was the night I moved out. I knew it was time to go. Here I am in good old Florida, picking in my own show. I hate that part. I gotta get something snappy, something that moves a little better. Is this any better at all? I hope so. Here I am in Florida, I'm picking in my own. Wait a minute. Don't tell mama, guitar picker, you think I've lost my mind. Mama knows where the guitar goes. Close behind. I could fight, drink, rob a bank, and I could raise all kind of... Well, don't you tell mama I'm a guitar picker. Can I do a song for you called the Guitar Boogie Shuffle? Remember this great old song? It goes like this. Oh, yeah.
Don't tell mama, 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 don't tell mama
Thank you, everybody. Oh, that's pretty close. There it is. I'm inspired by this fabulous audience. I'm going to dig down deep where the hot licks dwell, that are so dazzling but so dangerous that even the great guitar players won't go near them. Have you ever tried to play these licks before? Never. I've been saving myself for just the right audience. An audience that's wild and crazy, rowdy, full of fun, and ready to go. Okay, I'll keep looking. Wait a minute, this could be it. I say, let's take it to the mountaintop tonight. And all I'm asking from you is if I can get these hot licks right, would you all mind rising in the name of love, hold hands, hug one another, march down the hall to the front desk and moon them? We got people in here that do it. Let's see if I can get this for you. I'll take it. I'll take it. What an audience. Thank you, everybody. Wow. I'm full of love this very minute, friends. I'm a man that's full of love. You're looking at a man right now that is full of love. If you ever wondered what a man full of love looked like, you're looking at one. See if you agree. Am I full of it? Yes. Yes, I am. Why? Because I feel love in this room. Do you feel love here tonight? Well, if you don't, feel around you. It's here somewhere. If you love the one you're here with, could I have an amen?
Amen.
Now let's hear from the one you're here with. If there's joy in your heart tonight, could I have a show of hands? That's a beautiful sight right there. Joy in your heart tonight. How many of you ever think it's dumb to sit there in the dark with your hand in the air? How many of you? This could be a trick question. How many of you refuse to raise your hand? Okay. Can we turn the house lights up just a little bit? I want to do something right here. It's kind of fun. I feel like I already got to know you. And there's a way for you to get to know each other even better. And all you got to do is turn around, shake hands with the person behind you. Go ahead. Meet somebody if you have to at a different table. Say hello to them right now. Make a friendship that'll last a lifetime. Reach across and say howdy. You'll be glad you did. These people are the salt of the earth. You'll never regret this for a minute. Oh, look at this. These are the kind of people you can borrow money from. Do you feel like you know them a little better? You do? Then turn around and kiss the person behind you. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Now, the least we can do is sing a song together. Will you help me sing a song? I've been humming this little song all day. You ready? Zip-a-dee-doo-da, zip-a-dee-yay. I love this song. My, oh, my, what a wonderful day. Hello, plenty of sunshine heading my way. Hello, stranger. Zip-a-dee-doo-da, zip-a-dee-yay-yay. Mr. Bluebird's on my, you sound so pretty. It's the truth. It's actual. Somebody take it. Yeah. Zip-a-dee-doo-da. Zip-a-dee-yay. How y'all doing? Wonderful feeling. A wonderful day. I'm doing a show the other day. And somebody right down front kept going, zip-a-dee-doo-da, 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 over and over like that. I was sure they were crazy. I looked down. My doo-dah was open. But I'm walking on a cloud tonight, and I want to tell you why, friends. Here's why I'm walking on a cloud. Because this morning I signed a new contract with CBS Records. Are you proud of me? I can't believe it. It's a dream come true. Wait till you hear my deal. I get a CD every month. I can cancel at any time. So the other day I'm driving around, seeing it's raining. I love to drive in the rain. Don't you, brother? I'll get the windshield wipers. I was getting my windshield wipers going with an oldie. I was the oldie. And then I noticed the cars in front of me had slowed down too much. And the cars behind me had slowed down too much, too. That wasn't right. Plus, get this, they all had their lights on. I began to put it together. I had gotten myself into a funeral procession. I can guarantee you that it like to scared me to death, particularly when I turned into the drive-thru at Burger King and about half of them followed me. The only thing that's holding me together right now is the sound of laughter, the sweetest sound in the world. Is that the truth, friends? The sweetest sound in the world is the sound of laughter. And yet, if you let a laugh slip by, that laugh is gone forever. But when you feel a laugh coming, rise and walk again. But when you feel a laugh coming and you share it, you have made the world a better place. Is that the truth? Right. So when you feel a laugh coming, let it out. If you don't, it'll find its own way out. Do you want that? No. None of us wants that. No. No. This man right here is unafraid to have a big laugh. You're a good guy. What's your name, my friend?
My name is
Ken. Ken. Thank you for being here, Ken, and the lovely lady here, too. You did?
Years,
oh,
yeah.
Bless your heart. I was about 7 years old, I think, then. Yes, Ken. I got to ask you a question. And you know you're going to outlive us all with a laugh like that, Ken. That's a beautiful laugh. Now tell me the truth. Are you in a great mood or is your cell phone on vibrate, Ken? It's got to be one or the other. That is a fine man there. Look at there. And you're sitting right over here. Look, there's a gentleman right here. Here, coming through. Yes. How do I know you're a gentleman? It was written on the door you came out of in the lobby.
Yes, sir.
I'm glad to have you in here, my friend. There's another good man right there. Everywhere I look, there's a good guy right here, too, buddy. And look at this nice table here. I like this man here. Can I shake your hand? I love a man that cuts his own hair. I'll never forget you. I'm telling you, it's wonderful in here tonight. Wait a minute. That can't be true. Everywhere I look, I see good people. And I really appreciate it, too, friends. And Ken, while we were talking, somebody sat down back there, and I had to mark them tardy. I didn't want to. But they're a little bit late. I just saw him come in right there and sit down back there. We're proud to have you with us. As far as I'm concerned, you're a blessing. We all love you, and we're glad you're here. But you're late, and we marked you tardy. That's what we do around here. That's how it is. Rules is rules. But we're going to catch you up on everything you've missed. Right before you got here, we were all talking about the silliest thing that ever happened to us when we was naked. And it's your turn. Amen. Okay, I think I got a song for you. Let me go back up to my office here, and we'll see what's cooking. I wanted to do a thing. What was I going to do for you? I was going to do a thing called, oh, yeah. I got to do this song right here. Let's get this one going. You might remember this one. It's a little song called Spiders and Snakes. Yeah. Can you believe this old song? This is an oldie. I remember when Mary Lou said she wanna walk me home from school. Well, I said, yes, I do. Said I don't have to go right home, and I'm kinda like to be alone. Some of you would. I said, me too. And so we took a stroll. I wound up down by the swimming hole. She said, do what you want. Got silly and found a frog in the water by a hollow log, and I shook it out. And I said, this frog is you. She said, I don't like spiders and snakes, and that ain't what it takes to love me. You have to sing this old song, you remember it? I don't like spiders and snakes, and that ain't what it takes to love me. Like I wanna be loved by you. Woo! I think of that gal from time to time, and I call her up when I got a dime. I say, hello, baby. She said, ain't you cool? I said, do you remember when? And would you like to get together again? She said, I see you after. I was shy and so for a while, most of my love was touching a smile. She said, come on over here. I was nervous as you might guess, looking for something to slip down her dress. And she said, let's make it perfectly clear. Chris, would you help me sing it one more time? Here we go now, you ready? I don't like spiders and snakes, and that ain't what it takes to love me. One more.
I don't like spiders and snakes, and that ain't what it takes to love me.
Yeah.
Like I wanna be loved by you.
It's true, I wanna be loved by you. There it is right there. Well, thank you. Oh, gosh, it's good to be back in Florida. Man, I'm telling you what, it is really a pleasure to be here with you, friend, and that is the truth. We've just been treated so beautifully here, and we're very grateful for that, too. And I got to tell you, you know, I've been missing now for 20 years. I'm in a little town called Branson. That's where I've been. And I got to tell you something that's true, friends. I feel a little bit like the part of the history of that town, too. I feel like a little bit of part of the history of that town. You see, the truth is, I've watched acts come and go. I've watched performers come and go. I've watched attractions come and go. One of my favorites that's no longer with us there is Buford's Holler Hole. A fellow named Buford, a brilliant man, really, dug a hole in his front yard, and you could stick your head in there and holler for a nickel. I don't believe I have to explain to anybody how that caught on. People came from everywhere. They'd pack a lunch, they'd bring the kids, and they'd stand in line just to holler in Buford's Hole. It was fabulous. It brought the whole town together, I'm telling you. It really did. Well, people would argue about whether it was more fun to holler in the hole or to watch somebody holler in the hole. It's gone now. You know, sometimes these things come along that are just strange, different, unusual, and wonderful, and they go away and nobody knows where they went. They're just gone. In Buford's case, we have some idea. His dog died and he buried him in that hole. Now, we also had a wax museum in Branson, no longer with us anymore. We don't have that wax museum, and I don't miss it because the wax was bad. The wax was bad in that museum. It surely was. I can't tell you what's wrong with it. I don't know that much about wax. All I can tell you is if you look at a statue of Dolly Parton and walk away with wax all over your hands, something ain't right. I have a couple of kids that I'm proud to say I'm raising. I got a little Schaefer. He's not little anymore. He's 16 years old. And I've got Gigi. And she's 13 years old. And there's me, and I'm 65 years old. Guess who gets to look for a nursing home near a good school? I don't care. I'm having the time of my life. Little Gigi, she turned 13. She entered her teens the 8th of January, didn't she, baby? That's my wife, Annie, that she turned 13 on the 8th of January. And, you know, I can remember when we got her first Barbie doll. It just seems like yesterday. I took her down to the Walmart. I'll never forget it. Took her down to Walmart, and we picked out a Barbie doll, and we headed back to checkout, Grant. We were going back to checkout. We didn't make it, and I'll tell you why. Because Gigi said, Barbie needs clothes. Well, all the ladies in this room know that they don't have clothes for Barbie. They have wardrobes for Barbie. So we got Barbie a wardrobe, and we headed back to checkout. But we didn't make it because Gigi said, Barbie needs a house. You know what I said? She can live with us. But no, Barbie's got to have a dream house. So we go back and get Barbie's dream house. Now we're headed back to checkout again. We didn't make it, though, because Gigi said, Barbie's lonesome. What does Barbie want now? Ken. Let me tell you something, friends. She ain't even out of the box, and she's got to have Ken. Well, here's what I said. I said, I love you, baby, more than anything. But I'm old-fashioned, and I know for a fact that Ken and Barbie are not married, and I cannot allow them in good conscience to live together in that dream house. This ain't going to happen, and that's the end of it. How'd I do? The wedding cost me $300. But what are you going to do, right? They're your kids. That's just how it is. Yeah. And so anyhow, I got another song I want to do for you. I'm trying to remember what it was. I made a little list here because I just get lost all the time. My doctor said, Jim, do you suffer from memory lapse? I said, no, I enjoy it. I enjoy it. Let's see. What did I do? Oh, yeah, I want to tell you this. I found out something the other day that I should have figured it out. You ever do that? I found out something I should have figured out. I found out that Adam invented clothing, and I didn't know that. When they were kicked out of the Garden of Eden, there they were in the barren wasteland, Adam and Eve. Not a stitch on, and the rocks and the sand were so hot that Adam had to invent shoes just to get around. But Jim, he didn't put them on. Why? Because he only thought them rocks was hot till he sat down and tried to put them shoes on. Now, that's what happened. That's how it was back then. And nowadays, am I wrong about this? People wear anything you can imagine. They wear anything. My boy wears earrings. He's 16 years old, and he wears earrings, and so do all his buddies. He just wore one forever and went down to the mall the other day and got him another one. I'm proud. I'm proud that he ran out of ears. And none of his friends, not a one of them, none of the boys that he knows will pull his pants up. How'd that happen? These guys won't pull their pants up anymore. There are many theories on it. Some people say when the good music died, they all started wearing their pants at half-mast. Other people say it's the style. Does that mean that some kid woke up one morning and said, gee, I wonder if it'd catch on if I wore the seat of my pants between my knees like a mud flap? I'll try that. Maybe that'll work. And where does that leave the rest of us? Trying to figure out how we lived long enough to see a kid reach down here and come up with his wallet. That's what happened. And that's what we have to live with. Does it bother me? Let me tell you something. Not even a little bit. Why? Because they're kids. And they're supposed to do things that are daring and different. I kind of like it, tell you the truth. Not only that, they ain't hurting anybody with it. Plus, I don't care because, well, they're going to grow up one of these days and they're going to get a little older and they're going to find out something that we already know. They're going to find out that you hit a certain age where it don't matter where you want to wear your pants because your pants have their own ideas. And all they really want to do is rise like a tide. Am I telling the truth? 50, 55, 60, 65, 70, 75, 80. You live long enough, friends, you ain't nothing but pants. And that's the truth. Something to think about, I'll tell you. Now, the song I wanted to do for you is this little song right here. Maybe you've heard this one before. I hope so. Well, the wildwood flower grew wild on the farm. We never knowed what it's called. Some said flower, some said weed, and I never really gave it much thought. One day I was out there talking to my brother, reached down for a weed to chew on. Things got fuzzy, things got blurry, and then everything is gone. I don't know what happened, but I knowed I was gone, because I woke up when I wasn't there. I had to look around for my own self. I finally caught up with me in open pasture land, laying flat on my back with Hershey wrappers between my toes, beating on my chest, my head in a gopher hole, singing, I got friends in low places. I began to ask myself questions I could not answer. Questions like this. What did cured ham have? If bread always lands butter side down, and the cat always lands on his feet, what happens if you butter a cat and throw him out the window? This one has bothered me since my childhood. I'll probably never find the answer to it. Where is kingdom come, and how hard did mama really have to slap me to get me there? I come to, my brother was there, and he said, what's wrong with your eyes? I said, I don't know. I was chewing on a weed. He said, well, let me give it a try. Spent the rest of the day and most of the night trying to find my brother Bill. Caught up with him about 6 o'clock the next morning, naked, singing on the windmill. Said he flew up there. I had to fly up, get him down. Now I need your help on this last part, friends. Every time I wiggle my leg like this right here, if everyone would please go, oh, like that. Okay. It's something to do. All good things gotta come to an end. The same with the wildwood weeds. One day a fella from Washington come by, spied him turned white as a sheet. Yeah, he dug and he burned and he burned and he dug till he killed our cute little weeds. That was good. Let's try that again. He dug and he burned and he burned and he dug till he killed our cute little weeds. Killed our weeds and drove away. Yay is not a bad thing. Yay is a good, yay is a joyful noise. And I've got a leg I'm barely using up here. I say, let's make this yay. Okay, we got O and yay. It's getting a little complicated now. Killed our weeds and drove away. We smiled and waved. Daylight come and me want to go home. Hey yo, yeah yo. Daylight come and me want to go home. Everybody, hey oh. Drove away, we smiled and waved, sitting there on that sack of seeds. Y'all come back now, you hear? Oh, my word, I'm having fun. I'm having a wonderful time. And I can tell you something, friends. I can tell you this, that I'm extra proud that you're here this evening. And one of the reasons is because the economy is unstable. The weather's been unstable. I went to Subway today for lunch, asked for a po' boy, and they brought out the manager. It got to me the other night in Branson. I got to tell you about this. One of my favorite people, Reverend Chad Donnelly, Jane Alice. Reverend Chad Donnelly was in the audience. And he knew that something wasn't right. And after the show, he talked to me. He said, can you tell me what's wrong, Jimmy? And I said, well, I don't like what's going on out there. I could lose my house. I could lose my car. I could lose my theater. I might lose everything. I've got to have an answer. And he said, well, if you've got to have an answer, Jimbo, he said, you go on home and get out your Bible and open it up anywhere you want to, any page, it don't matter, and close your eyes and put your finger somewhere on that page. And then you bend down there and open your eyes and lift your finger. And your answer might be on your fingertips. And that's what I did. I went home and I opened up the family Bible. I closed my eyes. And I put my finger on a page somewhere. And then I bent down. And I lifted my finger. And there was the answer. I opened my eyes and there was two words. Chapter 11. If I did lose everything, I hope the first thing that would go would be the dog over at our house. He's not my dog. Matter of fact, he ain't even a dog. I'll tell you what he is, John. He's a chihuahua. That's what he is. And I didn't want him. My boy had to have it, and I tried to talk him out of it. I said, son, you're talking about a mouse on steroids. Think about it. How are you going to play with a dog you can kill with a frisbee? How are you going to do that? But he had to have that dog. And I got it for him. And I got to tell you the truth, I'm glad I did. It's been worth it, really. I'm not happy with his name. My boy wanted to name the dog Spot. And I said, son, they ain't never named a Chihuahua Spot. And they ain't never going to, because they're too little. That's what I told him. Just too little. So my boy calls him Speck. I should have kept my mouth shut. I really should have. But like I was saying, here's where it got to me. Got me right here. Because there's no sight any more beautiful in this world than a child and their puppy at play. It's the truth, ain't it? I ask you to picture this in your mind's eye, if you would. My boy likes to take his Chihuahua down to the drive-in teller at the bank and let him ride up and down in the little tubes. I don't expect you to believe this, but that dog got so excited down at the bank the other night, he left him a deposit. The real problem I found with that dog is this one. The real problem I found with that dog is that he loves to ride in the car. First off, he loves you like any other dog. He wants to be with you. He wants to go where you go. And he loves to ride in the car because you're in the car, and that's what makes him happy. But here's the problem. They're so tiny they can't see out. They can't see a thing. When this glorious country of ours passes by in review, a Chihuahua misses everything. They can't see out the window. This is going to break your heart, but it's true. They don't even know they went anywhere. I couldn't take it. I had to figure out a way for that dog to see out that window. I tried everything in the world. I tried, and I got weary from trying. And I dozed off. And while I was sleeping, a dream come to me. A dream come to me. And inside that dream was the answer I was looking for. Not at first. First it was cloudy in there and I couldn't see a thing. And then suddenly there appeared in crystal clarity 4 little suction cups and some duct tape. 4 little suction cups and some duct tape. And my dog can see. Is he happy? Well, if you call freaking out every time somebody tries to roll the window down, happy, I suppose he's happy. The truth is, of course, he isn't happy. And I blame myself. He's not happy, and I blame myself. I shouldn't be riding him on the outside. I know that. I got another. Oh, what am I going to do? Oh, yeah, I want to do another song. I got it. We're supposed to do an intermission. I don't want to go too far past that. Oh, yeah. Okay, I'm okay. I'm okay. Let's see what I got here. Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I can do that. This ought to work out good. Very good. Okay. Oh, I don't want this guitar. I want to do a cowboy song. I got a cowboy song. Actually, I got a cowboy song about a cowgirl. And I'm going to need my cow boy hat to do this song. And oops, here it is. I'll take it right here. Here you go. Okay. That's mighty fine there, partner. Okay. This is good. The reason I want this cowboy hat is because something about a cowboy hat. You put one on and it's almost magical. Something special happens every time you wear a cowboy hat. The next thing you know, it's true. And can you tell the difference? It's true. It's true for all of us. Anybody puts a cowboy hat on, something just right happens. I can't explain it. All I know is the next thing you know, you're talking like a cowboy, and you're walking like a cowboy, too. Yes, sir. Walking like a cowboy. Talking like a cowboy, too. Oh, it's fun. Maybe it's because we've all dreamed of being cowboys. I always wanted to be a cowboy, I tell you the truth. Actually, I was a cowboy. I rode bronc for a while. I wasn't any good at it. I had to give it up. Just too much danger. I knew sooner or later I was going to get hurt bad or maybe killed. So the day came when I had to make a decision. Is it just me or am I still wandering around up here somewhere? Well, I'm going to need your help on this song, and I needed my guitar, please. Could I have my guitar, please? I need my cowboy guitar. Oh, yeah, there it is. Thank you. Thank you so very much. All right. Come on out here in the light, honey. This is my wife, Annie. She's from Carthage, Texas. Hey, baby. Good to see you, sugar pie. Well, I need your help on this song. When you see this guitar neck go up like that, that's a signal for the sounds of coyotes howling. Can you do that? Ow! Down like that, signal for cattle mooing. Moo. Gonna have a gunfight in the song. Signal for gunfire. Bang, 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 bang. Somebody gonna fall down. Signal for falling down. Plop. When you see that signal, I need that sound. Plop. Just a moment. Did you see that? Look at this. Oh, my word. The hole fell off that guitar. The hole come loose on that guitar and fell off that guitar. Baby, can I have, I need to try this again. Thank you. It's okay, sugar pie. You're doing the best you can. What'd you bring me this time? A two-holer. A two-holer, honey. Got a vehicle in this song named Flame. You hear the word flame? I need this sound. Like a bunch of lot of fun to make that sound. Kids, help us with that. You do that sound better than anybody. And at the end of the song, we're going to have a stampede all the way around this building. It's going to be wild. Here we go. From the Badlands came the killer. Live with a knife and a gun. Shoot you just for standing. Cut you if you tried to run. He's big as a tree and he did as he pleased and everything he did was bad. They said if you was to kill him, it'd only make him mad. From the good lands came the cowgirl, Patty was her name. Hot on the trail of that killer, on a moped she called Flame. Friends, that was breathtaking. Killer killed her daddy just for spitting in the road. And you only had to kill Patty's daddy once to get that gal P.O.'d. Are you ready? Here we go. Yippee-yi-yi, cow Patty. Yippee-yi-yi, cow Patty. Rode into town to find the man that killed her daddy. Yippee-yi-yi. I believe I heard a lonesome cow in that bunch. I'm pretty sure about it. I think I heard a lonesome cow. Let's turn, bring it down a little bit so we can listen one more time. Let's bring it on down, way down, even more. We're listening for the lonesome cow. One more time. Okay. I think we just found a jackass in a tree. Killer hit town at daybreak, ate the door off the local saloon. He started to drink, you could tell he was thinking there'll be a showdown soon. Patty hit town in a cloud of dust, old Flame was buzzing like a saw. And the whole town got as quiet as a church when the killer stepped out for the draw. 40 shots rang out. 40 people fell. Wow. Patty and the killer missed each other, but they shot that town to pieces. Yippee-yi-yi, cow Patty. Rode into town to find the man that killed her daddy. Yippee-yi-yi, cow Patty. Killer took a step toward Patty. said it's time I gunned you down. But he slipped in something that was laying in the street and was shot before he hit the ground. Killer slipped in mooplop. It cost him his life, Patty said as she roared out of town. You gotta watch your step when you know the chips are down. Yay! Yay! Hell, Patty! There it is right there. Oh, my word. Thank you, everybody. Thank you. I appreciate it, friends. Thank you a lot. And I tell you what I want to do. I'm just about at the end of the first half, but I don't care. I got to do this song before I take a little breather here because I want to do it, and it's fun to do, and I hope you enjoy it. And it's not a cowboy song, so we're going to lose this thing. This is a song of Spain. Sorry to report that this song doesn't appear to be on here. Let me see if I can get this thing tuned right here. Hold on a second. I got one string that's weird. Okay. Okay, I think I got it. Here we go. All right. few minutes, friends. Thank you all. I'll be back. Thank you.
Don't go anywhere. Jim Stafford will return here at the Red Rose Grand Ballroom. Ladies and gentlemen, please get your seat. We're just about ready to start here. Before we begin, though, I thought we'd take a couple of moments for a little shameful promotion here at the Red Rose Inn and Suites. How many of you are having a great time tonight? All right. I've already talked to a few people. This is their first visit to the Red Rose Inn and Suites and also to the Red Rose Ballroom. We do hope you'll come back again and again and again and again. Our goal is to exceed your expectations in every way. Coming up in a couple of weekends from now, we will have a great show right here in the Red Rose Ballroom featuring the legacy of the Temptations Review. So if you would, please make welcome to the stage Polk County Commissioner Ed Smith, who's going to give a special presentation to Mr. Jim Stafford. Mr. Smith.
Thank you very much. Real pleasure to be here and to represent the county commissioner for Polk County and make this proclamation that we would like to present to Jim Stafford, or as I guess I knew him in high school as Jimmy Stafford. So Jim, if you want to come up, I'll I know this is a surprise to you, but I think I was a couple of years ahead of Jimmy at Winter Haven High School. So I'm a lot older, right? Anyway, I would like to read this proclamation. It says, proclamation from the Polk County Board of County Commissioners, whereas Jim Stafford was born in Polk County, Florida, on January 16. You don't mean to tell him that, do you? And whereas, while attending high school in Winter Haven, Florida, Jim Stafford played in a band with friends Bobby Braddock, Kent Lavoy, and Graham Parsons. And whereas Jim Stafford is a multi-talented comedian, musician, and singer-songwriter, and a self-taught on the guitar, fiddle, piano, banjo, organ, and harmonica. Whereas Jim Stafford has hosted, written, and produced radio and television shows. Jim Stafford's many accomplishments are a source of pride for his native Polk County, and whereas Polk and surrounding area residents will celebrate Jim Stafford's birthday with him January the 16th at Plant City's Red Rose Ballroom. Now, therefore, be it proclaimed that the Board of County Commissioners has hereby proclaimed January 16, 2010 as Jim Stafford Day. This is dated.
Woo!
Thank you. This is dated the 16th day of January 2010, signed by all the county commissioners and attested by Richard M. Wise, Clerk of Courts of Polk County. Congratulations, Jim.
Well, I sure do appreciate that. Thank you very much indeed. Thank you. Yes, sirree.
We're very, very proud of you.
Good deal. Thank you so much, Ed. Thank you very, very much indeed. And I really do appreciate this. I really and truly do.
And of course, Jim, now we can't have a birthday with it. Do you think we should have a cake? Yeah. Hey, come on. Let's get the cake out here for Jim.
Yeah.
Where's the cake? Here it comes. Uh-oh. We're gonna set off the fire alarm in here, Jim. How about a little round of happy birthday? All right, you ready? Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday. Oh, look at that. Thank you. Wonderful. Wonderful. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. I sure do appreciate it. And this is such an honor. And I would also just like to take a moment, if I may. I can't really think of all of my friends or even all my relatives, I don't believe, that are here this evening. We have so many of that. I want to thank everybody for coming by. And I would really love to share this moment with the lady who really went through most of this whole deal with me, and that is my sister Beverly. Would you stand up, Beverly, please? That's my sister Beverly. Thank you, sweetheart. Hey, Belle.
Thank you. I'm going to be all right.
Okay. All right, sugar. Yes, sirree. Well, thank you. And now, and I'm going to give this to my wife, Annie, for all of her support and wonderful or whatever. You can somebody's got to hold it. It ought to be you, I reckon. Jim Carlton there. Thank you, Annie Pye. And, well, seems like we're not finished here. Oh, let me tell you what I'd like to do, if you don't mind. And this, I consider this a huge honor, and all I can say is, again, thank you, everybody. Thank you so much. And let's stick around, and let's really have a party when I'm all done here, and we'll dance and carry on and have a couple of whatever. In the last 20 years, I've been passing out little audience cards in Branson. Every night, people will fill them out and send them up, and then we read them. And I've got a handful of them I brought with me just to read for the fun of it. So I'd like to do that for a moment, if I may. This is from Brad Johnson. I went to my doctor knowing I was going to get a shot. Okay, now that's enough of that. All right. Don't you hate when that happens? Okay. These are embarrassing moments, by the way, so that'll work right in. I went to my doctor knowing I was going to get a shot, and while I was waiting alone in the examination room, I dropped my pants to speed things up. The nurse came in and gave me a shot in the arm. Maxine Post wrote this one. Our tour bus was going past Red Rocks near Morrison, Colorado. The driver pointed out dinosaur tracks in the rocks, and one of the ladies on the bus said she was surprised they'd come down so close to the road. Okay, Millie Collier says, while in an RV park in Florida, I stepped in fire ants. I ran back to the RV to put my foot in the water to get rid of the ants, and while standing in the bathroom with my foot hiked up in the sink, I noticed a couple watching me. I was in the wrong RV. Audrey Danner, I teach school in Texas. My second graders were about to take an important test. One of them said, what do we get if we all make an A? I said, if you all make an A, I'll dance on the table. And one of the little boys said, my daddy will put a pole in for you. Bernice Medavoy, my three-year-old likes to take his pants off and run around naked. The other day he did it and bolted out the back door. I hollered through the screen, I know you're out there running around with your britches off, and a voice said, I'm just reading the meter, ma'am. This is James Stuckey. I had just started my own business. On the first day a customer walked in, I grabbed the phone and pretended to be busy. After a few moments, I asked if I could help him. He said, yeah, I'm here to hook up your phone. Jimmy Nell Kellum, I bought a hamster from the pet store, got it home, and it kept biting my kids, and my husband took it back for a refund. They said, we don't do refunds unless the animal's dead. My husband said, I'll be back in 5 minutes. Matt Jeffrey, I'm a state trooper. I was on patrol when a lady pulled out in front of me in an intersection and ran right into me and got out of her car a little disoriented, walked up to me and said, how'd you get here so quick? My four-year-old boy's dog died. This is Alma Grayson. My four-year-old boy's dog died. I tried to cheer him up. I said, maybe God needed a little dog to play with. My four-year-old said, what's God going to do with a dead dog? This one is just signed Don from the Walmart restroom. I was in a restroom in Walmart in a stall, and a man in a stall next to me said, "How you doing?" I said, "I'm fine." He said, "How are the kids?" I said, "They're all grown up." He said, "Well, how's your wife?" I said, "She's fine too." He said, "Can I call you back? The guy in the stall beside me thinks I'm talking to him." Well, now I need the house lights up just for a moment, if I may, please. This is something that we've done in the theater in Branson for 20 years. If we could turn there, they're not too bright. Maybe down just a little bit. I don't want to get too bright in here because it's not any fun for anybody. So maybe you cut them down just a touch there, for it's a little more comfortable. That's not bad. We're going to do roll call now, and if you've ever been called this name, we want you to please say "here." Are you ready? American. Yes. One of the most amazing things about an American would have to be their willingness to run into a burning building to save a stranger's life, or to volunteer to risk their lives for their country. Risk their lives, what more could you give? Can we ask all of our veterans in this audience to stand, please? Veterans, stand right up, would you? We'd love to give you a big round of applause. Thank you. These are the men and women who put their lives on the line to keep our country free. And we thank you. Thank you. Thank you, veterans. Wonderful. And I'd like to take a moment, if I may, to say a word about the ladies in our veterans' lives. These wives who had to stay behind. Their men went off to war. They had to get jobs, raise kids. A lot of them had to do things they didn't think they could do, but they did them. And you know what, friends? Truth is, they still do. And as often as not knowing moment to moment if their men are even alive. Well, if that ain't courage, I don't know what is. Do we have a nice round of applause for all the ladies in our veterans' lives? Thank you, ladies. Thank you. Thank you so much, all the ladies. And now, I would like to do a song for the ladies. And I can tell you this, let's turn the lights down now, it's okay. We're gonna go back and get nice and comfortable in here and do a song for the ladies. I want one of those. I got a plaque, you know. Okay. All right. A song for the ladies. You know, us men can be shy about admitting to how much better off we are with you ladies in our lives. We can be shy about admitting to how helpless and hopeless and pitiful and pathetic we were. I'm quoting my wife now. Even as a child, I had my problems with women. I wanted to get to know my Aunt Ethel. They shipped her off to prison. We never could figure out if she was a good woman with a mean streak or an evil woman with a heart of gold. My sister thought that she was an evil woman with a heart of gold, but I held out that she was a good woman with a mean streak. We'll never know for sure. She shot her husband with a bow and arrow not to wake up the children. And then, in sleepy little Winter Haven, we begin to play harmless little children's games. My favorite, spin the bottle. Most people remember it with a smile or a giggle. Here's how we did it. If I spun the bottle and it pointed to a little girl, she had to give me a kiss or a nickel. And I can tell you this without an ounce of shame. When I was 11 years old, I bought my first car. Now, if my daddy had just set me down and given me a good old father-son talk, the whole thing could have been different. But he didn't. Not only did I not get one, but I got to watch everybody else eat one. I'll get one in a minute. They look good. Okay. I lost my place again. What was I saying? Oh, yes. If my daddy had just set me down and given me a father-son talk, things would have been different. But he didn't. All he said to me about women was this. He said, son, he said, when a woman dresses up in leather, a man breaks out in a cold sweat and his knees go weak. You know why? I said, no, sir. He said, it's because she smells like a new truck. And so, I'd like to play this song for you, a song for the ladies on my harmonica. And I've had one of these since I was just a child. And we used to play these songs back home. Kids would all gather around, we'd sing songs and have a good old time. That's how it was way back there when I was just a little bitty boy, back in Eloise. No fancy gadgets back there. Didn't have no fancy gadgets, no computers in Eloise, where I'm from. They got one now. It was simple times back then. When I tell people that I went to school in a one-room schoolhouse, they don't believe me. All I had was a pencil and paper and the guy beside me. And he was dumber than me. We'd take a test. He'd write, I don't know. I'd write, I don't know either. Sometimes I'd just look at him and write, we don't know. And we didn't know. I didn't know and Putt didn't know. Neither one of us knew. And I still don't know. But I know a good song when I hear one. And my friend Pud gave me this one, and it's a dandy. And it's about a woman with a magnetic personality who falls in love with a man with a steel plate in his head. It's called Stuck on You. And here it is. Thank you. Well, the truth is, I would like to play a song for you that really is for the ladies. That, of course, is Shenandoah, which is not particularly romantic. But I would like to play this one for you, which I think is a romantic song, and I would like to do this for the ladies. This is from a movie. Do you remember the movie Somewhere in Time? That was a nice movie. And this is the theme from that movie. And it goes like this right here. And I gotta check my tuning. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. Thank you. Well, I was raised on country music. I still have my country western heroes, and I guess I always will. I got a couple of them can do something I know that I'll never be able to do. They can do a song for you that they wrote while they was in prison. I ain't never been to prison, and I just hope it's all right with you if I do a song for you that I wrote while Merle Haggard is in prison. None of us know for sure what it'd be like to be behind bars and all of a sudden thrust out into the real world. We can only imagine as we listen to this little song called I'm Getting Out of Prison Today. It goes like this. Well, the first time I met Dixie's in parking lot in Branson, I was sitting in my pickup all alone. She walked out of the Walmart, took one look at my truck, and she asked me if I'd like to take her home. She said she had a new place. We went to her old place, cause she said there's something she forgot to do. One hug and one kiss later, she unplugged her refrigerator. That's when I knew I was helping Dixie move. One of my favorite sounds is this sound right here. Can you make that sound? The first time I made that sound, I was just a child. We used to watch The Shadow on the radio. Who knows what evil lurks in the hearts of men? Who can finish it? The Shadow knows. My whole family would hear that, and we'd all go, ooh. Everybody except Grandma. Grandma wouldn't do it. Grandma'd just take her teeth out and scare us all to death. If you'd like to make that sound during this little story, feel free. It's the kind of sound you make when you turn the lights out and tell ghost stories. The kind of sound you make when we used to watch those old-time scary movies at the old Ritz Theater back in Winter Haven. And me and my buddies would walk into town and watch them. We'd stay in there till they chased us out. And by then it was deep into the night, and we had to walk home in the dark. Wouldn't walk on the sidewalk, too many shadows. We walk right down the center line of Main Street, holding hands, singing Jesus Loves Me. And could hardly wait to be scared to death again. And here's my little scary story for you. I hadn't done this one in a long time, but I always love to do it, and I'm dusting it off tonight. Fella called the cops. He said, I want to report a dead man on my front porch. The cop said, how do you know he's dead? And the man said, I don't know that he is dead for sure. I assumed he was dead. He's been laying out there now for about a month. Cop said, where do you live? And the man said, I live on Defuniac Street. And the cop said, how do you spell Defuniac? And the man said, D-E-F-E-U-N-I-A-C. And the cop said, Uniac is not spelling. You have to do better than that. How do you spell Defuniac? And he said, D E-F-E-P-U-N-E. With a K. A K. D F U N E. F E P U N E. F C K. K E. E K. D E F E P H E N E. F E F U N E. F U P U N E. P U F D. Capital D. I'm gonna have to call you back. The cop says, what do you call us back for? And he said, it's gonna take a while to drag this sucker over to Oak Street. Can't spell it. I can't spell it. I can't do it. And now, friends, may I do this song for you? I was, oh gosh. You know, you never learn one simple little thing like tuning, and it just affects you more than you think it would. There it is. That's pretty close. I was in Clearwater, Florida, playing a little place over there called The Shack on the Beach, and I wrote a song, and Kent Lavoie came by. He's our friend from Winter Haven who recorded under the name of Lobo. And he heard the song and he liked it, and he took me to Atlanta, Georgia, and we cut it in a little studio called Spring. I don't know the name of it, but it was on Spring Street in Atlanta. And lucky for me, the song did enough for me to be able to get a song in the top 40. It got to 39, so it just made it under the wire. But officially, it was a top 40 song, but just barely. Anyhow, I was lucky enough, though, that allowed me to have the opportunity to put out a second song. And I was staying at the 40 Winks Motel, working at Howard Steakhouse in Venice, Florida, when a producer named Phil Gernhardt came by with a little reel-to-reel recorder, and one of the songs on it was kind of an interesting little acoustic song that went, I don't like spiders and snakes, and that ain't what it takes to love me. Come on, love me, like that. I thought that was one of the best hooks I ever heard in my life. And that, of course, was by Dave Bellamy, who is one of the Bellamy brothers. I must say, he's always been a Bellamy brother, but not always been famous for it. And of course, those two guys have done just fine, David and Howard Bellamy. And as a matter of fact, don't they live in this area? I think somebody told me they had a ranch here in Plant City. But this is the first song right here. Blackwater Hattie lived back in the swamp where strange green reptiles crawl. And the snakes hang thick from the cypress trees like sausage on a smokehouse wall. For the swamp is alive with a thousand eyes and all of them watching you. Stay off of the track of Hattie's shack in the back of the Black Bayou. Way up the road from Hattie's shack lies a sleepy little Okeechobee town. And the talk of swamp witch Hattie lock you in when the sun go down. The rumors of what she'd done, the rumors of what she'd do, kept folks off the track of Hattie's shack in the back of the Black Bayou. They brought the rain, and the rain stayed on, and the swamp water overflowed. And the skeeters and the fever grabbed the town like a fist. Doc Jackson was the first to go. Some said the plague was brought by Hattie. There was talk of a hanging too. talk got shackled by the howls and the cackles from the bowels of the black bayou. Early one morn, between dark and dawn, when shadows fill the sky, there came an unseen caller on a town where hope run dry. In the square there was found a big black round vat full of gurgling brew. Whispering sounds as the folks gathered round, it came. Ain't much pride when you're trapped inside a slowly sinking ship. So they scooped up the liquid deep in the green, and the whole town took a sip. And the fever went away, and the very next day the skies again were blue. Let's thank old Hattie for saving our town. We'll fetch her from the Black Bayou. Party attend to the town's best men, headed for Hattie's shack. Said swamp witch magic is useful and good, and we're gonna bring Hattie back. But they never found Hattie, and they never found the shack, and they never made a trip back in. 'Cause a parchment note they found tacked to a stone. Thank you, everybody. Well, I sure appreciate that, and I'm just getting ready to get a chance to get out there, and you might say, wet my whistle and I want to visit with you. I'm excited about it. I've been excited about it since I got here, and I'm about to do it. But right now, I want to finish with one more song. And this right here is called a Mason Williams guitar. Mason Williams has a line of guitars out there, and he gave me one and asked me if I'd play it, and I said I'd be glad to, and I've been playing it ever since. And I might as well go ahead and play his song on it, because it's really one of the best guitar songs anywhere, I think. I like to close my evening with it, and I'd like to tell you, please keep in mind, friends, that the good folks at this beautiful, beautiful, wonderful complex here, I can't get everywhere I look, I see something beautiful here everywhere. It's just so magnificent. They asked me to remind you, and I promised I would do this. I almost forgot. Before you leave here, please don't forget to pull up a shrub for your home. That's a joke. Okay.
of entertainment will continue with PJ Lee and the Las Vegas Sounds in just moments.